Hey guys, welcome back to the next video. This time we're checking out a 32GB 7200MHz kit from Anaconda. Is this the best low profile DDR5 on the market? Well, let's check it and let's find out. Okay, so we have got a DDR5 kit here from Anaconda. This is the King Snake Edition. Now, they do have different variations when it comes to the overall speeds as well as capacities, from 8GB all the way up to 32GB, which this is. This is a 32GB kit, and they do have a variation of speeds as well. They go from 5600 all the way up to 7200, which this is 7200 mega transfers per second. And quite honestly, it does look sleek with this black shroud. It does look really, really nice. Now, this particular RAM doesn't actually show the CL or any other ones, but this particular kit is CL34. The timings aren't the best for AMD specifically. You are looking for either, I'd say, CL30 or CL32. That's generally the sweet spot for AM5. But this one does have a onboard ECC module. That does not mean that it supports ECC. That's generally with NAS or server work, which is generally specific DDR for that use case. This doesn't support ECC. All this has is a chip in the middle, which you've probably seen in other reviews, that is for error correction. That does not mean this will be supported in a server setting. This is particularly for desktop use, not server or NAS work. Now, as for this, according to them, this aluminium spread over here is made for gamers. I wouldn't really say that, because this is just a DDR5 kit. I mean, you could take this off and actually buy actual spreaders that would make it with RGB, or you could just buy a different kit completely without that. Now, this does have a built-in power management IC, which does make sure that the voltage doesn't go too high, so that's a very good feature as well. I think most DDR5 kits have that, but this is DDR5, this is 32GB, and this is 7400 mega transfer per second, which, no, sorry, 7200. I like to call it megahertz, but for some reason we got Linus Tech Tips and other people calling it mega transfers. But the only place that actually shows that as mega transfers is in the desktop in Task Manager. Other than that, if you look in the BIOS, it actually says megahertz. So yeah, let's get this on my DDR5 set, my system, which we will put this up against the other DDR5 kits I've actually got here, which do range from 5200 all the way up to 72. And then, of course, I got 64, 6000. So yeah, let's get this in my system. Right, okay, so when it comes to the overall testing, what did I actually use to test it? Well, I did use my main computer I use for gaming as well as editing. That would be my AM5 platform, which does have a 7900 CPU with a B650 motherboard and an RX 7800X GPU. So as for the kits I used, of course, the Anaconda 7200MHz kit. I also used Lexar Ares DDR5 at 6000, Predator Vista 2, that was 6000, Apacer DDR5 6400MHz, and Corsair at 5600MHz. Now, I've done it in equal parts. This will be specific for CINEBENCH R23. So for the Anaconda DDR5 at 7200MHz, the multi-core for CINEBENCH R23 was 28,298 with a single core at 1909. Lexar Ares 6000 was 28,271 for multi, single core was 1924. Predator Vista 6000MHz was a multi-core 28,653 with a single core at 1937. With the Apacer DDR5 at 6400MHz was 28,667 with a single core of 1913. And then the Corsair Vengeance 5600MHz kit was 28,216. And then the single core was a 1912. Okay, so 3D Mark Firestrike Ultra. This was done for physics as well as normal score. For the Anaconda 7200 kit, the physics score was 38,374 with an overall score of 12,826. The Lexar 6000 kit was a physics score at 38,554 with a overall score 12,729. The Predator Vista 2 6000MHz kits, the physics score was 38,688 with a overall score 12,873. Apacer 6400MHz kits, the physics score was 38,493 with a overall score of 12,768. And then Corsair Vengeance at 5600MHz was the physics score at 38,436 with a overall score 12,787. Now, for 3D Mark Times by Extreme, this was Extreme. So for Anaconda 7200MHz, the CPU score was 9,960 with a overall score 9,552. Lexar kit was 9,721 with an overall score at 9,522. Predator kit was a CPU score of 9,863 with an overall score of 9,588. The Apacer was a CPU score of 9,659 with an overall score at 9,493. The Corsair CPU score 9,609 with an overall score of 9,536. So, as for gaming benchmarks, now I have included three gaming benchmarks: Hogwarts Legacy, Assassin's Creed Valhalla, and Far Cry 6. So we'll start with Hogwarts. The Anaconda averages and the 1% lows were 102 for average with an 82 at 1% lows. The Lexar Ares, that was an average of 104 with 1% low of 73. The Predator was average at 104 with an 1% low of 71. The Apacer, the averages were 113 with a 1% low of 79. The Corsair Vengeance was an average of 105 and a 1% low of 92. This was actually high settings with a resolution of 3440 by 1440p resolution. So Assassin's Creed Valhalla, all high settings. Anaconda, average was 116 with a 1% low of 88. Lexar, the average was 118 with a 1% low of 75. The Predator, average was 119 with a 1% low of 75. Apacer, the average was 119 with an 1% low of 76. And Corsair Vengeance was an average of 118 and the 1% low was a 74. So, Far Cry 6, the same high settings at the same resolution. For Anaconda, the average was 150 with a 1% low of 116. Lexar, the average was 150 with a 1% low of 117. The Predator, the average was 146 with a 1% low of 112. Apacer, the average was 152 with a 1% low of 119. Corsair Vengeance, the average was 150 with a 1% low of 116. Okay then, so would I recommend this DDR5? Now, if you're looking for low profile memory, it does perform a little bit better than the Corsair Vengeance DDR5. But of course, it's all down to preference. But what's really surprising is the Apacer Panther DDR5 kit. That is the best performing kit out of all the tests. Maybe a little bit less in some, but majority of the tests, that one was just way ahead. So mainly gaming benchmarks, that one was just absolutely fantastic kit. Now, if you want to buy any of these kits, I will leave links down below. And big thank you to Anaconda for sending this out for review. I hope you enjoyed the video because it took a lot of testing just to give you the comparisons between six different DDR5 kits, and I really hope you enjoyed the video. Now, this is Richard from WELSHYTECH. Make sure you subscribe because I have got loads here. Joy Shark, I've got more thermal ride stuff coming. I have got more deep cool stuff. I've got other air coolers here from PC Cooler as well as AIOs. I have got absolute loads of stuff, monitors, everything coming. So make sure you subscribe. And as always, I hope you enjoy your weekend and week ahead of you. Goodbye.